This is Amrit Kaur from Guru Nanak Dev University and I'm a legal intern at Lexington Company. So let's get to know about today's topic. So the purpose of today's video is basically to get to know about marital rape and the issues relating to it. So first of all, it is very important to note down that rape has been a major problem all over the world, not only India but all over the world. So the basic meaning of marital rape is that the two persons are in a legal relationship and the wife or the husband has been forced in a sexual intercourse with their partner without their consent. So it is important to note that there is no consent regarding the sexual intercourse. So it is to be considered as a sexual harassment or sexual pressure on the spouse by the spouse. So in India, generally a marriage is considered to be a pure and sacred form and it is one of the most respected institution in the society. And it is almost impossible for the women to tell the society that they are being forced into sexual intercourse by their husband only. So it is basically that what will the society say, and it is a major issue regarding that. Also, this may be the reason behind the section 375 of IPC, that is the exception. So we can say that exception 2 of section 375 of IPC explains that the sexual intercourse or sexual acts by a man with his own wife without her consent, if the wife not being under 15 years, is not considered to be a rape. So this exception clearly states that the sexual intercourse by a husband with his wife who is above 15 years of age does not amount to rape or matrimonial rape. So it would be automatically concluded that they have been given consent to their spouse to have sexual intercourse with them whenever they want or whenever they need. So this exception is a major drawback also. So when we look at a case, that is Sakshi versus Union of India, it was pleaded in that case that marital rape should also be considered as an offence. But the commission only recommended to reduce the age of the women, and it was not considered to be as an offence, as a crime. So we can say that it is basically due to the customs, due to the old practices, conservative mindset, and the religious ideology that the marriage is only a religious sacrament and nothing else, nothing more than that, and there can't be anything wrong with it. So we can say that there are committees which have looked upon it, and one of the committees is Justice J.S. Verma Committee. And while evaluating the existing rape laws, they recommended that marital rape should also be considered to be an offence, as it is a crime, a heinous crime. And other than that, the committee looked into the matter of CR versus UK, and in that case, European Commission on Human Rights has stated that a rape is a rape, irrespective of the fact that it is a marital one or not. It is a rape. Other than that, the Domestic Violence Act 2005 has made a provision that wife can go for divorce on the ground of this, on the ground of sexual harassment by her husband. But it is not enough. It is an offense, as it diminishes the dignity of the woman, and it is not, this punishment is not enough that a woman can only go for judicial separation or get a divorce on the ground of sexual harassment by her husband. So it is not enough, and they demand an equal punishment for the marital rape to the husband also. And when we talk about fundamental rights, then Article 21 of the Constitution of India talks about right to live with dignity, and marital rape obviously violates one of the fundamental rights, as a woman can't live with dignity after being exploited or after being sexually harassed by her own husband, and the fact that they can't even tell the society about it, as this is a major ideology problem. And there is a leading case, that is a Chairman Railway Board versus Chandrima Das, that it was stated that a rape is not merely an offence under IPC against an individual, but it is a crime against the society also. So this problem can not only be vanished just by changing the mind of an individual, but there is a need to change the mindset of the society as a whole, as it would be impossible for the women to live with the dignity after such pain and agony she is going through her own matrimonial husband. As we all know that it directly affects her dignity, and sexual harassment is not a minor thing, it is a major issue. Another fundamental right, that is Article 14 of the is a main article of the Constitution, and it explains that the state shall not deny to any person equality before law or equal protection of law within the country. But exception 2 of section 375 definitely and clearly violates Article 14 of the Constitution, in a sense that it discriminates with the wife when it comes to the protection from her own husband. So it clearly diminishes her right of Article 21, as the women or as a female or as a girl below age of 15 years have the right of protection from marital rape, but a woman above 15 years have no such right of marital rape. So it is basically a discrimination. This offense is solely committed against a woman, and it is an infringement of her rights. So if you like this video, put a thumbs up on this video, and if you have any query regarding that, put your query in the comment box. And also don't forget to like and subscribe the channel Lex Click. And also it is important to say that this video does not solicit any promotion or advertisement as per the guidelines of the Bar Council of India, and it is for the educational purposes only. So yeah, that's it. Thank you guys.